day-to-day. Let's have your take on it. Your qualifying pace didn't put you at the front of the grid. Will this be a problem tomorrow? There are rumours that you're looking for a contract with another team. Is there any truth to that? Well, thanks anyway.
Welcome to the Yas Marina circuit for the finale of another thrilling Formula One season. It's been a breathtaking year, and we end it at a track that's been the scene of many glories and heartbreaks over its history. It's time to end the season in style. It's time for the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The Yas Marina circuit, just over 3.4 miles long with 21 corners and two very long back straights. There are two DRS zones going into the heavy braking zones of both Turn 8 and Turn 11 and offer plenty of potential for overtaking. The circuit comes with its fair share of tricky corners as well, in particular 15, 16 and 17, which will certainly test a driver's braking management. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into Turn 1. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Perez, Lando Norris, and Sainz, Russell, Ocon, Ricciardo, and Kimi Raikkonen, Leclerc, Stroll, Moore, and Gasly, Latifi. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Giovinazzi, Nikita Mazepin, they've taken a grid penalty. And Mick Schumacher, Tsunoda, and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Let's aim for a strong finish to the season. Let's aim for a strong finish to the season. Incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful.
It's been a roller coaster season then, but they can go into the winter with their heads held high after an emphatic victory here today. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection, a shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. Pick.
Lance Stroll certainly put in an impressive performance today. No doubt his team and fans are extremely proud.
It's another clear win for Mercedes as they managed to secure the constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.